Hey everyone, John here. Welcome back to another Sapphire tip. This is a Halloween based tip. I've been working on a bigger tutorial for a look I created for the film Christine. And this is the text look that I created in that tutorial. And I thought since we're so close to Halloween that I'd just do a quick breakdown for you. We've also included the actual After Effects project file. So if you want to open that and follow along, you can. Or if you simply want to just type in your own text and render, you can do that too. Let's jump in and I'll break this down. Now, the majority of the effects that I've used are Sapphire effects, but I've also used Continuum's Particle Illusion. If you don't have Continuum installed, you can always download the fully free version, the standalone version of Particle Illusion, and you can render out the smoke and bring that in as a footage file. Okay, so let's start by just breaking down the text. So I'm just going to solo that layer, come up and I'm going to turn off all of the effects. All right, so there's our ghostly text. And the first effect we have here is set matte. When I turn that on, you can see how we're revealing the text using a matte. And the matte that we're using is this one here. This is the Sapphire Wipe Plasma effect. And you can see I've just rendered a proxy here. Just sort of speeds up the rendering process a little bit. I like to pre-render all of my mattes. So what that is, it's just a white solid with Sapphire White Plasma applied, and you can see I've animated the white percent. So that's just wiping that on, and Plasma's got that kind of creepy look, which is perfect for this sort of Halloween based look. So I'm going to close that up. And this White Plasma is not only being used to reveal the text, it's also being used as the lens matte for the distort blur effect. Just select that again, and let's turn on distort blur. And watch what happens to the text. Instantly we get that lovely ghostly reveal. I love Sapphire Distort Blur. Let's take a look at what's happening in here. So for the lens, as you can see, I've used White Plasma. And just adjusted the blur amount and the blur lens and the rotate blur direction. Have a play with these settings and dial in the look that you like. Now I can increase the amount of blur, and actually looks quite nice if I increase that blur amount. And if I bring the blur lens down, you can see it's going to add a bunch more detail like that. Remember, it's using the white plasma as the lens. So the less blur of the lens, the more of that white plasma detail that's introduced. But I like it nice and streaky like this. All right, so that's the main effect, but you can see I've also used distort blur a second time. And before we look at that, I just want to come in and turn on the smoke. So the smoke was quickly created using Continuum's Particle Illusion effect. Quickly going to launch Particle Illusion and take a look at that. And if you're using the standalone version of Particle Illusion, you can find the preset I used in the Emitters 2020 library. Just make sure you've downloaded the free emitters. I'm going to type in smoke. And it's this one here, slowly rising smoke area. So add that to the stage and you can just change the size of the emitter and reposition it. And that's basically all I did. That gave me that quite convincing smoke. I'm just going to cancel that. And I've used the smoke as the lens for this second distort blur effect. Because we're using the first distort blur effect to give us that sort of ghostly reveal. But once that's finished, once that reveal's finished, then we basically have this text just sitting here and it's not looking very spooky. It's just kind of, you know, sitting here looking, you know, looking very corporate. So I wanted the text to be affected by the smoke. So to do that, under distort blur, for the lens, I've chosen the smoke layer. And because I haven't pre-rendered this smoke, I've just chosen effects and masks. So if we just turn that on, you can see because I have the blur lens rather high, it's giving us a sort of ghostly distortion being caused by the smoke, but it's not giving us the detail of the smoke. If we brought blur lens right down, you can see then we're getting that smoke detail in there. And we don't want to go too low because then you can't read the text. Now, below that, I've also used Sapphire Distort. And Sapphire Distort is once again using the same smoke as the lens. And blur lens is rather low, and you can see that's adding a little bit of extra detail there, but it's not blurring the layer, it's just adding distortion. Watch what happens if I bring blur lens right down. See how we're getting the detail of the smoke, but it looks slightly different from the same low blur setting in distort blur. So that's quite nice. You could go quite low and you can still read the text. Probably a little bit too much for me. I just wanted to add a little bit of extra detail. So using those two effects together. Below that we have Sapphire Ultra Glow. And what I wanted to do here was give this kind of a smoky look. And I was able to do that using the atmosphere setting inside Ultra Glow, which I often use. And by turning, you can see by turning atmosphere off, now the text feels like it's kind of sitting in front of the smoke. But if we turn that on, now it kind of feels more integrated into the smoke. And I often use that trick when I'm using sort of smoke or mist or that kind of thing, and I want to more integrate my layer with Sapphire Ultra Glow applied by using atmosphere. That's nice. So that's the base for the text. Now, below that we have Sapphire Gradient Radial. If you've watched any of my tutorials, probably 99% of them when I use Sapphire S Gradient Radial. And that's just, they're positioned in the middle here and giving us this blue. So if we put the text on top of that and we put the smoke on top of that, and you can see smoke has the screen blend mode, and we're getting this blue color. All right, so almost done. On top of that, and this is something I often do as well when I'm working in After Effects, is I'll use adjustment layers just to dial in the final look. And here I've used Sapphire S Gamma just to darken this down a little bit. Let me just turn this on just to darken that down. So that's just by just tweaking the gamma a little bit. And a second version of Sapphire Ultra Glow over the top, just to add a little bit more ghostly glow, but this time without atmosphere turned on. And that's the final look again. Now, as I mentioned, one of the reasons I wanted to do this obviously is because of Halloween, but I developed this look for a larger tutorial for this Christine look that I created. And this tutorial will be coming out soon with a lot more detail. I'll be going into how I use Blender to create the car for Christine. And there's a whole lot in this one which I think you'll find really interesting, so look out for that soon. But for now, have fun. Hopefully you'll create some nice spooky graphics with this look, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.